Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi ji, Excellency President of Republic of Armenia, Excellency Prime Minister of Latvia, distinguished ministers and officials from our partner and focus countries, Denmark, Germany, Japan, Netherlands, Italy, distinguished ministers from Poland, Serbia, Sri Lanka, USA, chief ministers of Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, my ministerial colleagues, industry capitals from across the globe and India, senior officials from states and governments, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to welcome each and every one of you here today. For those who have traveled across the globe to be with us here, I extend my warmest felicitations and heartfelt gratitude. Today is indeed a historic day in the history of the food processing sector of India. Our first mega event, World Food India 2017, has brought together on one platform, under one venue, for the first time, 7,000 stakeholders across 60 countries, over 8,000 exhibitors, more than 75 international and national policymakers, heads of states and governments, 60 top global CEOs from across the globe, more than 100 top Indian CEOs from across India, 12 ministerial and official delegations, 18 business delegations, round tables with the Honorable Finance Minister, Prime Minister, Commerce Minister, interaction with 7 central ministers and 37 state ministers, over 36 conferences and sessions with over 5,000 B2B, B2G meetings planned over the next 3 days, and an expected over $11 billion worth of MOUs to be signed over the next 3 days. Under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, as India gears up for a revolution in the food processing sector, it is absolutely clear that the global companies are eagerly looking towards India for collaboration. As one of the fastest growing economies in the world, having a 1.3 billion population base, a $600 billion retail sector set to treble to 1.3 trillion by 2020, and 70% of this sector in food retail. India is the third largest economy in terms of purchasing power, and our demand for food is set to double over the next 5 years. Being the sixth largest food and grocery market in the world, India is indeed a destination that merits global attention in the food sector. Being one of the largest producers of food in the world, as well as one of the largest consumers, we are keen to improve our processing levels at the moment what we process only 10% of what we produce. To process more, to reduce our wastages, have more food available for our increasing population, the government over the last 3 years has taken a number of reforms and a number of economic policies have been put in place to promote food processing. Creation of 42 mega food parks across India, with a hub and spoke model of creating common facilities for food processing where investors may come and plug and play without having to put in the entire capital expenditure which goes into setting up this huge industry. It's an economical way of putting up more units. By putting up a unit in every mega food park, it makes you closer to your potential retail markets as well as helps you meet pricing in a competitive manner. We're working towards creating a cold chain grid throughout our country for seamless transfer of food from production to consumption. The recently launched Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, a new scheme envisioned by the Honorable Prime Minister, where over $1 billion worth of incentives is going to be distributed to create infrastructure worth $5 billion over the next 3 years. with major policy decisions like 100% FDI in retail of food manufactured and produced in India, we're working to create huge markets that this infrastructure can feed. Goods and service tax, one nation, one tax, a major economic reform undertaken by the Honorable Prime Minister recently, has indeed made India a destination where ease of doing business has now become a reality for all investors. Under the dynamic vision of our Honorable Prime Minister to reform, perform and transform India's food economy, we look towards partnering and collaborating with the best technologies in the world. In Sanskrit, we say, Vasudeva Kutumbam Kutumbakam, which means the whole world is one family. And in Gurbani, our great Guru says, Ek Pita Ekaske Hambarak. There is one father, we are all his children. This is our planet, we are equal stakeholders. As we move towards 2050, where the world population is set to increase by 25% and the demand of food set to increase by over 50%, we all need to come together to wage a war against food waste. To ensure adequate food for all, let's all come together, learn from each other's technologies and expertise, share our experiences and our technologies, so that what may be a business opportunity for one country may be potential for another country. And with our mutual collaborations and partnerships, as we expand our economies and as we expand our footprints, may we also nourish humanity by ensuring adequate food for all in times to come. I once again take this occasion to thank each and every one of you being here, especially excellencies from Latvia and Armenia, and my personal and heartfelt gratitude to each and every one of you for the tremendous response and faith that you have shown by being here for World Food India 2017. As we look towards discovering newer markets and increasing our footprints, may World Food India provide you with those opportunities of collaboration. And may the Ministry of Food Processing, I may assure you at this point, stands committed to help and handhold industries for concretizing and fructifying partnerships. With these words, I especially thank the Honorable Prime Minister for his faith, his support, his vision to double farmers' income and to transform India's food economy, and for being here today to be a part of this event. Sir, as always, we thank you for your leadership and continuously look towards you for your guidance. Thank you so much.